Hello friends, welcome to my channel, myself Parag Dambulkar. In this video, we will talk about ordinal types. So, ordinal types are those types whose values or range of values can be associated with the set of positive integers. So, when we say positive integers, that means we are including 0. So, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 onwards. So, those values whose values can be associated, can be linked or can be compared with a set of positive integers including 0. So such kind of types are called as ordinal types. So there are two types of ordinal types. One is primitive ordinal types and second is user defined ordinal type. So see, primitive ordinal types, so our integer, character, boolean, all are primitive ordinal types. Primitive because those are the built-in data types. And why they are ordinal types? Because they can be linked, they can be associated with a set of positive integer. How? We'll see. So see, integer. So we know integer, what values it can have? It can have negative numbers, just like minus 4, minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, then 0, then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 onwards. So here you can see 0 that we have, then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, those are the positive integers, directly we can link with that, and negative numbers. So if we negate this positive integer, so we will get negative integers. So this is how integers, all values of integers can be associated, can be linked with set of positive integers. Then characters. So all characters, they have ASCII values. So if we take a C++ language, so all characters, they are represented by the ASCII code. So there are 128 characters, so starting from 0 to 127. So all ASCII values, so 0 to 127, again those are the integers only, set of positive integers. So this is how characters can be linked or characters can be associated with positive integers. Then Boolean values. So what values are possible, true or false? So normally we say true as a 1, we link true as a 1 and false as a 0. So 1 and 0, again it is a positive integer, set of positive integers. So this is how values of integers, characters and booleans that we are linking or associating with a set of positive integers, and because of that, these are the ordinal types. So anyhow, these are the primitive types. Primitive type means built-in data type. And ordinal types, why ordinal types? Because we can link them with a set of positive integers. Now see, we will talk about user-defined ordinal types. So we have two user-defined ordinal types. One is enumeration and another is subrange. So here we will see. So enumeration type. So enumeration types are the types, we can say user. It is the user defined types. Their values are user defined. So we are defining a type whose values are user defined, and all the possible values are the named constant, are the constant values of this enumeration type are the constants. Now see, whatever the values that we are using for the enumeration type are called as enumeration constants. For example, here we can see. So in C++ language, we can define enumeration or enumeration type like this. So enum is a keyword that is used for that. Colors, that is the enumeration type. It is a user defined type. Then these are the possible values. Red, blue, green, yellow, black, whatever the values we have mentioned there. Then this is the type, this is a data type, okay, we have defined it, it is a user defined data type, and for that we have used this keyword enum. Now see, now we are defining a variable of this user defined data type. So we are defining two variables, one is my color and another is your color. So what values we can allocate or assign to this variable? So any value from this that we can assign it. So for example, see, for my color variable, we are assigning blue. Your color variable, we are assigning red. Likewise. Now see, why it is the ordinal type? Because these values are associated with the positive integers, set of positive integers. How? So see, it is associated with the 0. It is associated with the 1, 2, 3, 4. So if you add more, then again, it will get incremented like that. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. And if you add again, so 5, 6, 7, 8. Like this. So this is how we define enumeration type in C++ language. So we'll see program for that. So see, this is a C++ program. So here, enum keyword is used. Colors is a type, user defined type. Any name we can give. This is a, we are defining a type here. What are the possible values? This. And it is linked with the set of positive integers that I have told already. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Now see, this is a color type. We have defined that user defined data type. My color is a variable, your color is a variable. What value we have assigned to my color? Blue. And your color is red. Now we are printing on the screen. So see, if you run this program, so what output you will get? So now we will run this. So here you can see. So my color, what value we have assigned? Blue. So blue is the second one. So 0, 1, 2, right? 0, 1. So that's why 1. Then your color is red. So red is first one. So starting from 0, 0, 1, 2. So that's why it is 0. So your color is 0. So likewise, this enumeration type is implemented in C++ language in the same way it is implemented in C language. So this enumeration type first introduced by C and Pascal language, and afterwards C++. So in C++ language, it is taken from the C language only. In C++, enumeration constants. So see, whenever we are seeing enumeration constant, so enumeration constant means these values. These are the enumeration constant. So red, blue, green, yellow, black, these are the enumeration constants. So in C++, enumeration constants can appear in only one enumeration type in the same referencing environment. Now see, what do you mean by that? Here in this example, so see, one type I have defined, that is the color. Now suppose, if I take new data type, suppose, and another name I am giving, so for example new colors, and I am allocating some values. So suppose these values I am allocating. So what I have done, I have defined new type. So first was colors, and now I have defined another data type, that is new colors. Now whatever the values I have added here, same values I am putting there. So red is there, blue, again I am taken from here, green also I have taken, but this is not allowed in C++ language. So see, red is present here also, and red is present in here also. So red value, it is present for the new colors also. So this is not allowed in C++ language. So if we run this program, so we will get error. So see, if we compile this, so we will get error. So what kind of error we are getting? So redeclaration of red, redeclaration of blue, redeclaration of green, as we are redeclaring it. So enumeration constants cannot be used multiple times in C++ language. So this is the meaning of this sentence. Enumeration constant cannot be reappear. It cannot be reused. But in ADA language, it can be reused. It cannot be reused in C++ language, but in ADA language, it can be reused. So enumeration literals means enumeration constant. It can be reused. And that's why enumeration constants in ADA language are called as overloaded literals. Literals mean constant. So they are called as the overloaded literals. Why overloaded literals? Because they can be used in multiple definitions. That's why they are called as overloaded literals. But it is possible in ADA language only, not in C++ language. Then what are the advantages of enumeration data type? So there are two advantages. One is readability and another is reliability. Now see, what do you mean by readability? So they have the values. So here they have value 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. And instead of using values, here we are using names. And that's why it becomes more readable. So instead of some value. Now see, by default it has some value 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We can allocate our values also. For example, see, if I want to allocate this value 10, 9, suppose I want to allocate some other values 4, 5 and suppose 3, something like that. So if we want to allocate our own values, we can allocate it. Now see, we'll compile it and we'll run it. So my color blue, that is 9, and your color red, that is a 10. So we can define, we can allocate our own values to this enumeration constant. So instead of this codes, we are using these names, words, and that's why it is more readable. Then why it is reliable? Why it is reliable? Because see, in this example, whatever the values are allocated, so 10, 9, so only these values can be used. There are no other values can be allocated to this enumeration constant. So what, while defining this, whatever the values we have mentioned, only those values can be used. Outside these or other than these, no values can be assigned, and that's why it is reliable. So these are the two advantages of enumeration. Now, so already we have seen example in C, C++ language. Now we'll see how enumeration is achieved in Java language. So see, go through this sentence. All enumeration types in Java language are implicitly subclasses are of the predefined class enum. Now what do you mean by this? So we'll see one example. So see, this is a program written in Java language. How enumeration type is defined? So see, again here just similar to C++ language, we are using keyword enum. This is the enumeration type, user defined data type, and these are the values. Now see, one thing is important here, this is considered as a class. Here this enumeration type is considered as a class, and whatever the type that we have defined, it is a class and it is a subclass of predefined class enum. So enum is a predefined class with E capital. So enum is a predefined class in Java library, and whatever the enumeration types that we are defining, all are subclasses of this enum class. So in this case, in this our example, this is a subclass of enum class. This is a subclass of enum class. Now see, so again in the same way, just like we have seen example of C++, so same way we are taken here. So we are defining two variables. Now see, it is a class. So as it is a class, so these will be the objects. My color will be object. What value we are allocating? Blue. Colors.blue, because these are the constants. So as these are the constants, as in Java language, constants are defined by the final keyword. So these are the final values or final constants. So this is the constant. So we are accessing it by using this class name colors, colors.blue, and again this is a colors.red. So that two values we have allocated. Now see, we will run this program. So here we are printing it, my color and your color. So we will run this. So we'll compile. Now we will run this. Now see, here we got my color is blue, so that we are allocated here, and your color is red. So same way we got the value. Now see, these are the objects, right? These are the objects. Why it is the object? Because this is a variable of this class. This is the class. Enumeration types are the classes. So this is the object. As it is the object, we can call some method also. For example, see, if we call this method ordinal, this is a method. If we call this method, so it will print index objects. So index will be like this 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So that indices will get print. So we will run this. So we will compile this. And now we will run this. So see, initially we got the values blue and red. And this time we are calling this method ordinal method. So this time we got 1 and 0. So that indices we got here. Just like in our C, C++ language. So this is how enumeration is implemented in Java programming language. Now we'll see some examples from the other languages. So in C sharp language, in the same way, just like in C, C++, enumeration type is defined like this. And they are assigned some values, integer values 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, like this. In ML programming language, so in our C, C++, Java and C sharp language, we use keyword enum. While in ML programming language, we use keyword data type. And in F sharp programming language, we use keyword type. So how it is defined? So see, instead of enum, we are using keyword data type. And these are the possible values. So here we mention in C, C++ language, we mention like this. Here we are mentioning values like this. So those are separated by this or. By this or. Monday or Tuesday or Wednesday, like this. While in F sharp language, so instead of data type, we are using type keyword. And first value, so Monday is the first value. So it should get preceded by this or symbol. See, that is the only difference between ML and F sharp. So what is the difference? Instead of data type, we are using keyword type, and for these values, it is preceded. First value is preceded by this symbol or, like this. So some languages like Perl, JavaScript, PHP, Python, Ruby, Lua, they do not allow enumeration data type. So these languages do not allow enumeration data type. Now, another enumeration type that we'll see, that is a sub-range type. So see, from the name we'll come to know, it is sub-range. From the given range, we are finding the sub-range. So, simple example. So, integer type we know. So, what are the possible values are there? All negative numbers, zero, all positive numbers. So, these are the possible values of integer. Now, if I take part of it, so for example, see, 12 to 14. So that is a sub-range. So what values are possible here? 12, 13, 14. 12, 13, 14. These are the possible values. So it is a sub-range of integer type. It is a sub-range. We can say subset of the main set. Now see. So sub-range types were introduced by Pascal and Ada language. So Pascal language, Ada language, they support these sub-range types. Again, there are two advantages. They are readable. So they provide readability and reliability. So why readability? Because see, we are taking subset of values. So that's why it is more readable. So instead of having big range, we have a small range. And that's why it is more readable. And why it is reliable? Because see, we can allocate the values from that range only. So for example, see, if you declare this sub-range 12 to 14, so we can allocate values from this range only, 12 or 13 or 14. And that's why, so So no other value other than this are allowed, and because of that it is reliable. Now see, we'll see some example. So ADA language, so it is supporting this subrange, and to implement subranges it has this type, subtype. So see, in ADA language we are defining one type, days, and what are the values? Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, these are the possible values. And then this is a subtype, or that is subrange of type days. So see, we have taken subtype weekdays, of type days, and the range is Monday to Friday only, Monday to Friday. So here we have taken up to this only. So see, from these possible values we have taken subset of this, subrange of this. So this is the subrange, only this part we have taken. So to implement subrange in ADA language we have this keyword subtype. So again see, subtype index is integer range 1 to 100. So another type that we are defining, and in this type what are the possible values? Only from 1 to 100. So 1, 2, 3, 4 up to 100. Now see, in subranges whatever the operations are possible for the parent type, so all these operations are possible for the subtype. So parent type, whatever the operations those are allowed, same operations we can perform on the subtype, except assignment of values outside the specified range. So whatever the values those are mentioned in that range, in that subrange, only those values can be assigned, outside that we cannot assign it. So this is called as the subrange. So in this way we have seen two enumeration types. One is enumeration, and we have seen how it is implemented, and then we have seen subrange. So these are the two user defined ordinal type, and primitive ordinal types are these: integer, character and boolean. So friends, I hope you like this video. If yes, then click on like, subscribe to the channel, and don't forget to press bell icon so that you will get notification of my next video. So stay connected. Thank you.